This guy is a bulldozer with a wrecking ball attached. He'll leave a ring around your eye and tread marks on your back. He's an animal. He's hungry. You ain't been hungry since Supreme Clientele. Remember what you first told me when I took you in. You wanted to be a fighter. You wanted to be a killer.
New York,
you wanted
stand
to
up.
Be the champ.
Scott, you your boy in the booth, nigga.
Matter of fact, I don't want you in my
gym. About to take New York against you. Just play.
George from the Youth and Community Center was set up for kids to come in, no matter how old you are, start and learn to box, because boxing makes leaders. You don't have to be a follower, and that's why this place is here.
There it is.
What about a lot of people see, you know, they see it as fighting. What do you think about that? You say it's more of an art?
Boxing is all about art. As a matter of fact, you got to know exactly what you're doing at all times. The baby bull was just telling me a moment ago about staying in shape. You can be the best fighter in the world, but be caught out of shape for a long period of time, and someone can win and beat you. So this is all about conditioning of mind as well.
So when you're back in here, you're back in your second home.
This is it, climbing up those steps. Like, oh no, not again. Still frightening me, but it's the best thing that ever happened. Yeah, the future, it's the future. I mean, strong, strength, just like his dad was a young boy. Just the other day, I see his son snatching those right hands out. Boy, it's a beautiful thing to see.
So what are your other plans?
Well, my plan is just to stay active, to make certain that along with my son George Jr., we showcase talent in the Houston area.
Heavyweight fighter, we've got entrepreneur,
minister. Wouldn't that be good if we're able to promote his next title match and he become champion of the world? Wouldn't that be something? I'd fall down the ring crying. I'd cry. Let's do it. I like that. Let's do it.